If the minute hand is 4 inches, find the area of the whole clock. Okay, if the minute hand is 4 inches. Okay, the minute hand is the longer hand, isn't it? So what are they really trying to describe to us? The minute hand would represent the radius. So we're saying the radius is 4 inches. What is the area of the whole clock? What area is pi times radius, which is 4 squared. So 16 pi inches squared would be our area. Okay? What would the circumference be? Well, circumference is what formula? D pi. And if our radius is 4, what's our diameter? 8. So we're going to plug in 8, stick a pi next to it, and stick inches next to that. So it's 8 pi inches. And if you needed to know the more application part of that, you just take 8 times second arrow, which is pi, and we get 25.13. So that final answer would be 25.13 inches. Okay? So there's number 4. Now let's look at number 5. Number 5 says, if the minute hand is 4 inches, find the area of the sector created by the hands of the clock at 2 o'clock. Okay, so we actually have to take the information from 3 and 4 and put it together. So we're looking at the same clock that we were looking at earlier. We've got a circle. We've got a radius that is 4, and we're looking at 2 o'clock, okay? So we need to know this angle measure to be able to figure out the sector area, because remember, sector area is the measure of the arc over 360 times pi r squared. So that's our sector area formula. So, whoops, let's zoom out a little bit. There we go. So there's our sector area formula. So we need to know the measure at 2 o'clock. Well, 2 o'clock covers 5, 10 minutes, right? That's 10 minutes, which is how many degrees? Well, we said each minute represents how many? 6 degrees. So 10 minutes times 6 degrees per minute, that gives us 60 degrees. Okay, so it's 60 degrees over 360 times pi r squared. Well, we just figured out our area in the previous problem. So we've got 16 pi as our area. So I'm going to just plug in 16 pi. So what's 1/6, because this reduces to 1/6, times 16 pi? Stick a 1 underneath that. That gives us 16 pi over 6, which is what? 8/3. Pi is our sector area. If you need to put that into decimal form, we take 8 divided by 3 times second function caret to get the pi, and it gives us 8.377, or 8.38 if we round to the closest hundredths. And that's going to be in, what unit is that? Inches. Inches squared. Area is always squared. There you go. So that is how you would figure that problem out. So you're looking, using your formulas, deciding what you need. Always draw a picture. That's first strategy. Draw a picture, label it, write your formula, and plug in what you know. Those are good practices.